So why clawhammer banjo? Or maybe more importantly, what is clawhammer banjo and how is it different than other forms of banjo music? Boy, when I got into banjo, I guess it was 14 years ago now, I had no idea that there were other types of banjo music. I thought banjo was just banjo and I never really thought about it. I just wanted to learn how to play. Turns out there are lots of different styles of banjo music. Most of us are familiar with the scruggs style or bluegrass style banjo that uses finger picks and picks a rhythmic pattern for the most part. And that's what Earl Scruggs played and what most bluegrass music is made up of. But there is so much more. There is classical banjo played by banjo orchestras with each banjo playing its own little part. There's Irish tenor banjo, there's ragtime banjo, and there is old-time banjo, and the most common way to play old-time music is with clawhammer, and that's what I like. And that's this downstroke style where you pick one string with the tip of your index finger or your second finger, whichever you prefer. And then you use your thumb to either pick the fifth string, which is a short, kind of a drone string, or you can pick another string. So you can double thumb or drop thumb. And I'm really rusty. I don't play the banjo as much as I would like to. I really intend to get it out almost every night, but I'm lucky if I get it out about once a month. And I used to know a lot more tunes than I do now. So don't look at my banjo picking as being what clawhammer really sounds like. Do a web search and maybe find some other clawhammer banjo tunes. Matter of fact, I'll pick something out and I'll put it up here in these links over here and find some really good clawhammer tunes for you to listen to, some people that actually know what they're doing. Me, I'm just having fun. I'm one of those people that failed at guitar lessons as a child and was told to sing real quietly in the church choir and pretty much just believed I had no musical talent. And while I don't speak the language of music the way a lot of people speak the language of music, I can learn to play. And one of the things that makes that so much more doable are these little electronic tuners that actually tell you whether you're in tune or not. And that will tell you if each string is tuned properly. It looks like I need to tune a little bit. And that was always my biggest problem when I was growing up trying to learn to play the guitar, is I could never get it in tune. It was always way worse after a week of trying to practice at home than it was when I went home from my lesson each week. And finally, my guitar teacher told my parents, maybe this wasn't the thing for me. But with the electronic tuner, I can at least make sure I'm in tune and I can memorize the mechanics of playing. I don't really hear the music and then have it flow out my fingertips, which would be the ideal, and a lot of people have that skill. Hopefully I will learn that skill one of these days, but so far, I'm still somebody who recites music instead of speaks the language of music, if you will. Now when I talk about bluegrass versus old time, a lot of the tunes are the same. You're still gonna hear tunes like Old Joe Clark, Devil's Dream, Cripple Creek, things like that are all still very common tunes either way. But in bluegrass, it's usually about highlighting each individual in turn, the vocalist, the banjo, the mandolin, the guitar, the fiddle, and there's rarely more than one of any given instrument playing in a bluegrass group. It's very much stage-oriented performance music. Whereas in old time, it's more musician-oriented music. It's for the people who are playing to sit back and enjoy and just get lost in the music. So everybody just kind of plays along the whole time and they don't take turns trying to show off and highlight. They just play in tune with each other and in time with each other. But everybody's going to be just a little bit different in the way they finger the notes. So if you've got three banjos, one may be more melodic, one may be more rhythmic, and that just adds to the flavor of the music. And they'll get lost for 10, 15, 20 minutes playing the same tune over and over again, kind of in a trance. And that's really where I would like to be with playing banjo music someday. And hopefully I'll get there if I ever start practicing more, because it's not gonna happen if I don't practice. Now, what is the banjo I'm playing? This is an Ohm. It's an Ohm Jubilee. It's an open back banjo. Bluegrass banjos typically have a resonator, or a big reflector to resonate the sound back towards the audience, and they have big, heavy brass or nickel silver tone rings that really make for a sharp, clear tone. This banjo just has a wooden tone rim. It's turned so that it has good contact and good sound, but there's no metal ring in here. Some open back banjos that are played for old time do have a metal tone ring. Lots of different banjo styles and options out there, but this is very basic. It was probably the most affordable banjo Ohm was making at the time. But the only thing I really paid extra for, I think, was to get this little bit different shaped peg head. This is not a normal banjo peg head. I just thought that would be kind of interesting to have something like that. Right now I've got another old antique banjo. This is just kind of a wall hanger. I don't really play it. Maybe I'll get it out one of these days and do a video about it and talk about why I don't play it too much. But this has been a wonderful instrument. So I'm really glad I invested in a good quality banjo. So I'm going to get back to my practice session here today. We'll see you for the next video.